Assalamu alaikum. My name is Maria and I am a class teacher of class 6. And I'm also taking SST in class 4 to class 5. And this is Know Your World 5, Social Study for Pakistan by Farhad Mansoor. And our today's topic for lecture is Explorer. The meaning of explorer is a person who explores a new or unfamiliar areas. Today we are going to talk about the famous explorers. Geographical exploration is travel on land, by sea or in space for the purpose of discovering unknown areas of routes. People who undertake such journeys are called explorers. Explorers have different motives. For example, who amongst us does not want to know what is over the next hill? Even as children, we have a desire to explore beyond the familiar street of our neighborhoods. There are some men who want to accomplish something so great that their names will be remembered after their deaths. Some countries want to be pioneer in certain fields in order to make the among the nation of the world. In 1453, following the capture of Constantinople, the Ottoman Turks blocked the overland route from Europe to Asia because there was such a great demand for Indian spices and silk in Europe. At that time, many European explorers undertake voyage to find a new route by sea to India and China. European church leaders also wanted to send missionaries to convert the people of other lands to the Christian faith. European kings wanted to extend their power by establishing colonies overseas and become richer by taking gold, silver, precious stones, and other natural resources from their colonies. Now let's talk about some important explorers of the time were Marco Polo, an Italian explorer, 1254 to 1324. Marco Polo came from Venice in Italy. His father was a merchant who imported goods from Asia. When Marco Polo was 16 years old, his father took him on a long expedition all the way to China. They sailed from Venice and continued their journey eastward across land, traveling through Turkey, Armenia. They reached the great pearl market of the world. After 3 years of traveling over the mountains and plains of Silk Road, surviving many life-threatening situations, they reached China. They were overwhelmed to discover the riches of Asia. Marco Polo met Kublai Khan, the ruler at the time, whose enormous power and riches amazed the young Italian. He stayed with the Khan for 17 years and acquired great wealth in jewels and gold. He went across the Karakoram Mountain and beyond the plains of the Indus Valley. His journey through Asia lasted 24 years. He was the first European to cross the entire continent of Asia and leave a record of what he saw and heard. On his return to Italy, he completed his experiences of his travels and Kublai Khan's life and empire in a book. Marco Polo's travels influenced European trade and resulted in further exploration by the European people of Europe. Now let's talk about Ibn Battuta, an Arab explorer, 1304 to 1377. Ibn Battuta was born in Tangier, Morocco. He started his travel at the age of 20 in 1325. First, he traveled to Mecca with a caravan to perform Hajj. Though the journey was dangerous, he was fascinated by all he saw while passing through Egypt, Syria, and Palestine. The account of his travel to Islamic countries was most useful, since before this there was hardly any information available about them. After he had performed Hajj a